Before I begin, I just want to say sorry for not posting chapters of my series, or not my series, but the series I'm reading, that is Hawk's Sister x Bakugo. All the times I've been reading fanfiction, I've forgotten to read them, but I will be reading chapter 8, Hero's Training Exercise Part 2. Let's begin. Alright, let's begin the indoor combat training. Alma's voice boomed through the speakers. Team A and Team D, your time starts now! The class and Alma observed from the monitor's room. Izuku and Uraraka climbed through a window into the building as you used your wings to fly up, swiftly landing. Your wings stayed extended for the exercise you decided. Careful, there are a lot of blank spots, Izuku warned, continuing to walk through the hallways. Uraraka and you followed, but to avoid causing more noise than you needed, with your footsteps, you gently hovered a few inches over the ground. Checking around the corners and beginning to edge was probably caused by the darkness of the hallway. The building gave off a very intimidating appearance, so you all were on the edge for Bakugo and Ida's the villains. Before thoughts could wander further, Bakugo jumped up from behind a corner. And he scared the F out of me, and when I was... Oh, the person writing the series said he scared the frick out of me when I rewatched this episode. Okay. Back to the fanfiction. He meanly swung a right hook to Izuku and Uraraka, but you shielded them with your wings and pushed them to the side. Bakugo left a few burns on your arms, but he did a number on your wings. What's the matter, Deku? Afraid to come up to fight me? Afraid to come fight me yourself? Bakugo asked as the smoke cleared. He scoffed at your form. Texting his shitty nerd must be freaking irritating. You could just join my side, he smirked. You were struggling to get back up on your wings when signing and smoked. Bakugo darted toward Izuku again, but Izuku counterattacked by grabbing Bakugo's right arm and swinging him over and slamming him back into the cold corner floor. Caution, you always use a big right hook to start a fight. I know because I've watched you for years. Izuku spoke, breathing heavily. Uraraka helped you onto your feet. I analyze every amazing hero, even you. It was all in the notebook you burned and threw away. Bakugo looked pissed off. You can call me Deku, but I'm not some helpless, defenseless kid anymore. You hear me? I've changed, Izuku screamed at him. From now on, Deku is the name of my hero. Deku is the name of a hero. By surprise, Bakugo stood and yelled, I hate you. While his hands sparked like crazy, your instincts were quick and you jumped up and dove in front of Izuku with your wings stretched out, but still sore. You uppercut Bakugo's jaw with your knuckles, so he stumbled back, giving Izuku time to get out. Izuku, Uraraka, get the weapon! I'll stall him! You turned your head to speak to them, while keeping Bakugo in your
I can't read that word, I'm so sorry. In your vision, I will just say that.
Izuku stepped forwards in the fighting stance. No, I'll fight with you. He knew it was the personal reason for all of this, so he subsided and nodded at Uraraka to sign her to go on. As Uraraka left, Bakugo left towards Izuku while swinging his left foot in a high side kick, but he slid under him and wrapped some capture tape around the same foot. Thank you for the tip, Izuku. Izuku I'll let you lean a couple peeks at his notebook holder, revealing his secret nose on a razor head. God damn it, Bucko screamed as he was about to fall, but he recovered before he hit the ground and swung another right hook at Izuku. He thankfully missed Izuku as he dodged it and he glided across the floor from the impact, standing next to Izuku. Damn it, Izuku, why won't you use your quirk to help? He internally questioned. He got into a fighting stance as did Bakugo. You could see him smirk a bit at you, but you ignored it and prepared to use your feathers, which has grown back. Suddenly, Izuku grabbed your hand and dashed through the hallways as you yelped from surprise. Get back here, you frickers! You heard Bakugo yelling in anger. Izuku, what gives? You asked while stumbling all over as he dragged you harshly. I can't attack at close range. We need a plan. He replied, not changing his movements or line of sight. You could hear the explosions and yelling, but it was also muffled with your thoughts. Jeez, I've never seen Bakugo with so much hate in his eyes. It's scary. Izuku finally stopped, and as you could crouch nearby a corner to catch your breath, as you were panting wildly. God, seems like you forgot about Uraraka, Izuku indicated. You nodded, but Izuku, Bakugo and Ida aren't working as a team, you pointed out subconsciously. Izuku looked at you surprised from your observation. Ida is clearly much faster. He could have captured us in seconds, which means Izuku mind clicked. Kasha's gone rogue, he nodded at his discovery. Hey man, you know a lot about this stuff. Your detective skills, instinct and reflexes and overall power is impressive for a new hero in training. How do you do it? He asked. Your eyes widen and you wave both your hands in front of you. I watch a lot of action movies. Yeah, you lied. Izuku was about to say something when you intervened. Anyway, I got our stagery. We need to stay split up to ensure our time doesn't run out. I'll keep Bakugo busy while you go and try to help Uraraka. Izuku nodded. Uraraka informed us that she was on the fifth floor. That's right above us, he said, while getting up, helping Izuku to do the same. He heard an explosion. Whoa. What are you, a GPS? Bakugo asked from behind you and Izuku. His grenade guns flashed red and made a weird noise. I'm all loaded up, he said in a dead, cold voice. What does that mean? Izuku asked shakily as you whistled that your feathers would grow faster. Bakugo smirked. Since you're such a stalker, I'll let you already know how my quirk explosion works, he scoffs. You kept your guard up. I secret nitroglycerin like sweat and it makes it blow up. Imagine what it would do if I had a lot of it. He clicks the lock on his right gotten. Gauntlet to reveal its pin. That's right, the gauntlets are not just for show, they've always been sorting my sweat inside for a monster blast. He growled lowly. Oh no, change of plans. Predicting what's going to happen, he prepared to protect Izuku. You could hear Amak telling Bakugo to not do it. They'll be fine along these dodges, he said as he pulled the pin, with a smile like a maniac. A huge explosion was approaching you as you sharpened your now fully grown feathers out of